Welcome back to the series. Wearing my Goosebump shirt, didn't have a Are You Afraid of the Dark shirt, and you'll find out why Are You Afraid of the Dark is a subject for this video. It's not the main subject, but it correlates. Anyway, this is episode 8 of Review Rewind. Last week we talked about Mary-Kate and Ashley, It Takes Two. Great movie. This is, in fact, your first time checking out this series. This is a weekly video series where we take a look at a movie from the past, review it for you guys in the present. Hope you guys have been enjoying this series. It does take a little bit of effort to put out every week and the Saturday video, but it's been a lot of fun, so yeah, we're gonna keep rolling for a little while. But yeah, this week's video is, as if you've seen last week's episode, you know what it is, Almost Partners, a great mystery. It's not a murder mystery, because it's like, why don't we give too much away right now? We'll talk about it a little later. But it is a mystery about two detectives. But why Are You Afraid of the Dark is significant? Because the director, Alan Kingsberg, was a writer mainly known for writing TV shows such as Are You Afraid of the Dark? He also wrote some episodes of Doug. Great, love Doug. Great, great series. When it went to Disney, it dropped a little bit, but I enjoy Disney's Doug, especially the movie. He also, Doug, and then he did a few Pokemon series. So he was mainly a TV guy. Are You Afraid of the Dark? Probably his most famous, well-known project. This being his most famous movie he directed. Probably a lot of you guys have no idea what Almost Partners is, and you're missing out. If you have not seen it, go find it somewhere. Definitely check it out. It's a great, very entertaining mystery. We talked about the director, and then the most famous person is obviously Paul Sorvino. There we go. He was in Goodfellas. He was in Dick Tracy as Lips Manless. Love Dick Tracy. So much. Probably more than most people. Sugar Guy sequel. Probably a bit too late now, because Warren Beatty is getting up there in age. He probably wouldn't be able to do his own stunts again. But great movie. Love that movie. Anyway, off on a little tangent. He was also in Sea Spot Run, which is a great comedy starring David Arquette and Anthony Anderson, who I've personally met on the set of Till Death. I'm like, what show was it? Till Death, which I have an autographed copy of the script. But yeah, let's get into what this is about. Is a mystery. Molly, if you guys can see that, Molly McHugh is a 14-year-old obsessed with mystery stories, who has developed an eye for clues and longs to test her skills on a real case. The opportunity knocks when an urn containing her grandfather's ashes turns up missing. Determined to crack the case, Molly teams up with Detective Jack Weider, who's Paul Sorvino, a tough New York City detective. When the unlikely pair begin to uncover clues, they discover their case is much bigger than they suspected. The evidence points to a connection between their case and the biggest mystery in New York City. Great movie. I don't know why it's not rated. I guess they just didn't feel the need to go to a rating system. Somebody stole Grandpa and Molly's on the case. Now, unlike Clubhouse Detectives, this DVD artwork is an improvement over the VHS artwork. I think this one is much better than that one. Unlike Clubhouse Detectives, who photoshops in a random kid in there, this one does not. Improves it. You got New York City and then the magnifying glass. Great, great DVD cover artwork. Variety says an entertaining presentation with mystery and humor. Timeless family classics. Love this movie. Oh, this was released a year, was it 87? I believe it was 87, so like a year before my birthday, May 16th, I think I got the screen grab of that, May 16th, 1987, so very cool. The first time I watched it was actually, we rented it from the library. For you kids out there who have no idea that library, of course, I do follow someone on Instagram who their library still has media. So that is cool. My library does not here in Macon. Maybe somewhere else in Georgia does, but mine definitely does not. Anyway, we had this huge library in Tifton, and they had a whole section in the back for kids, and they had VHS you could check out with your books and watch and then bring it back. So every Friday after school was out, if we did good that week, our dad would take us to Blockbuster or sometimes a mom and pop shop nearby. I forget what it was called. Way too young to remember. I was like 7 or 8. But then we would go to the library and rent some as well. Because you could get like 2 at Blockbuster for like, I forget what it was, like $7, $8. And the library was free, obviously, so our dad really liked that option. But yeah, that's the first time I rented Almost Partners. And then for years I searched for it. And we finally found it at a video warehouse sale. They were selling all of their VHS. So we both grabbed a copy and a copy of Punks, which is a great movie starring Jessica Alba. I believe it was her first role. Go look that up if you haven't seen it. So yeah, I was very excited to find Almost Partners very excited. So, great mystery, not a murder mystery, just a mystery. There we go, getting rid of the shadow. But if you have not seen it, go check it out. Probably a lot of you have never seen this movie in your life. So, definitely go check it out. Alright, that is going to do it for this week. Tune in next week. We'll have two movies we will be reviewing. Alright, so that is going to do it for this episode. Go watch, I should say what they are, The Dollhouse Murders and Adventures in Dinosaur City. So go check those out and we'll talk about them next week. Bye.